You're watching the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
From the Weather Channel, a severe weather update.
We have had numerous reports of hail tonight, also some very damaging wind and tornadoes, very numerous too across the country. Thanks for joining us here on the Weather Channel. I am Lisa Spencer along with Jeff Morrow this hour to give you an idea of where we are looking for the strong to severe thunderstorms. You can see it here in the red shaded area and also into the orange areas as well. So we'll certainly want to keep our eye on this vicinity as we continue through the evening hours. Numerous watches have been issued, so we will certainly want you to pay attention with this. We'll keep you updated on exactly what is going on across the area. Give you an idea of some of the locations where we're looking at some strong to severe thunderstorms and some of the scenes from it. There are scenes from a neighborhood in Ripon, and there we have certainly had at least one confirmed tornado touchdown earlier this evening. Sirens went off just before 6 Central Time, giving people in the area plenty of warning. Several homes damaged and trees down and power lines still out in many areas. No injuries have been reported. High winds damaged about 17 buildings in the Morris area this morning. Trees were down and some utility poles fell through houses. Mayor Richard Daley has declared or is planning to declare an emergency this morning. Now that puts the wheels in motion for people to get city help with storm-related problems. Of course, we have numerous watches to tell you about this evening all across the Plain States, not so much the Plain States now, but in parts of the Midwest as we can take a look now. These are in the Southern Plains. As you can see here, a severe thunderstorm watch in effect until 2 o'clock local time includes portions of Oklahoma and also areas of Texas. And our next watch takes us a little farther to the north. This is for Illinois, right on over to parts of Ohio. Certainly an area to watch this evening. Now our next watch is going to take us on up to Wisconsin until 11 o'clock local time. And another watch, this is a tornado watch until 2 o'clock local time. Keep in mind this means conditions are favorable for the development of a watch in and around this red shaded area. And there is a severe thunderstorm watch that is in effect until 2 o'clock local time for the southwest corner of Pennsylvania. Certainly another area that we'll continue to watch as we progress right on through the evening hours. The next watch for portions of Maryland and also areas of Virginia, you can see there in the yellow shaded area. So certainly our radars this evening are blossoming with the strong to severe thunderstorms across the country, and we'll keep our eye on this area. And we have a look at some of those radars right now with Jeff Morrow.
Okay, thanks a lot, Lisa, and we'll go ahead and talk about severe weather coverage. Well, let's go to the storm reports first. A little bit of behind the scenes movement there. Here's a look at where all the severe weather has been. Again, all the red triangles, and boy, we've seen a tremendous amount of tornadoes this evening. Illinois, parts of Minnesota, Wisconsin, northern Indiana, into Ohio, also down here into some areas of Oklahoma. Some reports of damage, no reports of any fatalities, maybe a few injuries. We'll keep you updated on this, but we've had a pretty major severe weather outbreak as we've had on through the evening hours. And it's not quite over yet. Still, where you see the very bright orange and red here, parts of Pennsylvania moving on down over the northern Chesapeake and the Delaware Bays, those are the tops of some tremendous thunderstorms, which keep reforming and moving down over the same areas time after time after time. That could not only cause the gusty winds and the hail, and also the heavy rains, but also maybe with the heavy rain and the same storms moving over the same area, some flooding, other big storms moving up into Michigan now, and a big cluster very persistent in extreme northern areas of the state of Texas. It's all ahead of this front and along this warm front just south of it in a very warm and sticky air mass. First of all, we'll go on the eastern end of this, then we'll progress to the west and show you all the thunderstorms. Big line moving down just south of Baltimore now, right across the Bay Bridge and on over just south of the Dover area. So some very gusty winds and some heavy downpours there. Then another cluster, a little bit of a break, and then another cluster moving through the Johnstown and Altoona areas, moving generally in a southeasterly direction, and another cluster forming northwest of Pittsburgh. So again, they keep moving in the same general direction. If you head far enough upstream, up into Jackson and up toward Kalamazoo and Lansing and Grand Rapids in Michigan, yet another batch of storms there as well. Things have calmed down a little bit around Chicago and Madison earlier. Several reports of tornadoes here, but still some big thunderstorms southwest of Moline. And as we head even farther to the southwest, We get on down here around the Joplin and Springfield areas, some isolated locally heavy storms in Missouri, and then look at these big storms down here south of Wichita Falls and on over south of the Ardmore area, just north of Dallas. It has pretty much stayed just north of the Dallas-Fort Worth metroplex, some of the northern suburbs getting hit, and on up toward Lake Texoma. And a severe thunderstorm watch has been extended here until 2 a.m. local time. So still some big problems in this area. Now, as we look ahead to the forecast, what I wanted to show you here is, first of all, the normal jet stream flow for this time of the year, with a jet stream well to the north and a couple of weak disturbances riding along it, very warm conditions to the south. But boy, that's not the case we have now, with this big cool pocket punching south into the warm and actually hot and humid air. That's what's causing the severe weather. It looks like things may return to more of a normal flow by the time Thursday rolls around. All right, let's go ahead and take a look first of all at what's going to happen with this whole frontal system. Again, the northern end of it moving faster than the southern end, the jet stream really pushing this front all the way into New England, but it hangs up down here to the south, and that could be setting the stage for some flooding problems in parts of the southern plains and lower Mississippi Valley. There's that front on Wednesday. Notice that the northern end of it does move faster than the southern end. It kind of gets stalled down here. Along and ahead of it, that's where we'll look for showers and locally heavy thunderstorms once again. Rather cool air, actually even chilly for this time of the year, in the northern plains, parts of the western Great Lakes, and a new system moves into the northwest with some rain there. Again, along and ahead of this front, and we may even have to beef up some of this rain and fall amounts here in Pennsylvania, as again, the systems are moving over the same areas time after time. Very warm and muggy out ahead of the system, still very chilly behind it. Here's a look at the high temperatures as we head on through the day on Wednesday. Even some triple digit readings from the Sand Hills on down into parts of South Georgia. And there's a look at Thursday and on into Friday's highs. Still stays pretty warm and definitely muggy over the south. We're definitely into the summer regime down here already, but then a new pocket of cool air moves into the northern Rockies by the weekend. Here's a look at precipitation. Here's our front, and it's going to have a tough time pushing to the south, I got to tell you. It's probably going to get hung up here. Best chance for rain in parts of the south would probably be on Friday, and then the system falls apart as it sags farther to the south. Here's our next system moving out into the plains. Now, it, depending on which computer model you look at, may not be quite as strong, so maybe not the severe weather outbreak that we saw with this last system, but stay tuned, things could change as we head on into Sunday while the west coast dries out, and it looks like we may be setting up for a rather pleasant Sunday in the northeast.
Doing it wet, doing it hot, everybody's doing it, doing it.
For fun on the water, everybody's doing it. See your local Sea-Doo dealer.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Current regional conditions. Special regional information. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. The regional forecast. The extended forecast. We'll be right back.
your local radar, showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
Ice cream, you scream. We all scream for ice cream. We all scream for ice cream.
Yeah!
Thank you. Hershey's chocolate syrup.
To you, it's just a pill. To us, it's where promises are kept. Sun kept. You have our word on it.
Do all luxury cars deaden your sense of hearing? Your sense of touching? Feeling the road? Not when your luxury car is one of the new BMW 5 Series V8s. Their sense of the road reduces the competition to senseless luxury.
To arrange a thorough test drive, simply phone your nearest BMW dealer.
We're keeping a watchful eye tonight. We have severe thunderstorms that are moving across the Midwest. We'll have details on those storms coming up. Numerous watches have been issued. So stay with us right here on the Weather Channel.
The people at Canterbury Clocks realized that to grow, they had to switch gears. So Joe called Microsoft and asked for this free video for Lotus and WordPerfect users. The timing was perfect. He saw how upgrading their software could save time and effort. How with Microsoft Excel, they could add profits. And chart their progress. Word for Windows showed them how to communicate clearly and emphatically with their entire organization. Now Canterbury Clocks has more time to build their business. And Joe, he got a big hand. Millions of people like you are making the switch. So call for your free video and see for yourself how Microsoft Excel and Word for Windows are changing the face of how business does business.
Strong, severe thunderstorms across the country tonight. We'll have complete details in just a few moments. But first of all, let's check these forecast cities for tomorrow. Starting...
Getting rave reviews. The Philadelphia Daily News calls 1-900-WEATHER the best telephone weather service available. 95 cents a minute, 1-900-WEATHER.
Your first time buyer.
Ever try to buy a car?
I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
Only to have your credit rejected?
What do you people take me for, an idiot? Get out of here. Get lost.
Don't give up. Come to Maroon Pontiac. Our business was built on getting people financed, and we'll go the extra mile to get your credit approved. There are car dealers, and there's Maroon Pontiac GMC Isuzu in Wayne.
In addition to our famous outlet stores with their quality products at fantastic savings, Old Lafayette Village is home to many specialty stores and eateries. You'll find items from A to Z that are certain to please and delight everyone in the family. Discover Old Lafayette Village for a relaxing shopping experience right in your backyard. Old Lafayette Village, Routes 15 and 94 in Lafayette.
Watch the 5-Day Business Planner here on the Weather Channel at 20 minutes after every hour. You get a comprehensive national report that covers the forecast over the next 5 days. Watch the 5-Day Business Planner coming up soon on the Weather Channel.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the current conditions. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. For cities nationwide. Forecast. The current local radar showing any precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
What do you do with your yard waste? Corner it and ignore it? Bag it and drag it? Or have you tried ways of composting that take forever and really stink? What can you do with your yard waste? Now with the unique Kemp Compost Tumbler, you can turn yard waste into garden gold, natural, sweet-smelling fertilizer. Simply load your compost tumbler with anything organic. Close the door and give it a quick turn. And a good turn every day. Then, in only 14 days, you'll have nutrient-rich, all-natural fertilizer. The Kemp Compost Tumbler. Try it at home, risk-free for 30 days. There's no obligation. Call this toll-free number now for more information. And find out how to get all the natural fertilizer you'll need to give your garden a real boost, whether you're a new gardener or a real pro. Turn to the Kemp Compost Tumbler for all your yard waste disposal problems. Call now for more information.
Thanks so much for tuning us in here on the Weather Channel. We've got a lot of watches, severe weather watches, and warnings to get through. Let's go ahead and show you, first of all, the watches. And we'll start it off with a new one here in Texas. This actually replaces one that was due to expire about 15, 20 minutes ago, but they extended it because of some big thunderstorms down here over North Texas, which we'll look at in a bit. A couple of pieces of tornado watches out still for northern Illinois and parts of northwest Ohio until 11 p.m. local time, and then on up into eastern Wisconsin until 11 p.m. local time. That's for about another 40 minutes. And then on over into southern Michigan, some big storms here, even including the Detroit metropolitan area. Those tornado watches are out until 2 local time. We head even farther east and we pick up a severe thunderstorm watch, and this one's out until 2, and there have been a whole series of storms moving through this part of the country and on down into our last severe thunderstorm watch until midnight Eastern Daylight Time for parts of Maryland, eastern West Virginia, Virginia, and even on down into parts of Delaware as well. I'll tell you what, let's show you some of the damage. This actually occurring from severe weather last night. This shot in the southwest corner of Minnesota. High winds tore through a mobile home park near Tracy, Minnesota, sending close to 100 people to a National Guard armory for shelter overnight. 17 homes destroyed, several others severely damaged. Meanwhile, close to the South Dakota border in Laverne, storms toppled tractor trailers, blew roofs off buildings, and bent flagpole. So again, some nasty weather last night. And of course, we've seen a lot more of that as we've headed on through the evening hours tonight. All those red triangles indicating where there were tornado touchdowns. And a lot of those from Minnesota into Wisconsin and parts of northern Illinois. Again, still some big storms down here in parts of Texas and on up into Pennsylvania as well. It's all along just south of this warm front from Pennsylvania back into Michigan and Wisconsin and along the cold front all the way down into parts of Oklahoma and Texas. Big storm south of Baltimore and also just southeast of Johnstown now. We head farther west, another little cluster up near Youngstown, then on up into Michigan, some storms Jackson, Lansing, on up to Grand Rapids. Still some rain, but it looks like the severe weather quieting down a little bit in Wisconsin. Let's head farther on to the south. Big storm around the Joplin area, but check out these big storms north of Dallas right along the Red River.
Oh, looks like Betty's got one.
Way to go, Betty.
Get ready, he's gonna run.
Not if I can help it. Gotcha!
Mom's gotta keep a line on her kids, because she's gotta keep reapplying that sunblock every time they come out of the water. But now there's new Copper Tone Kids 6-Hour Waterproof Sunblock. It keeps a kid protected from the sun and waterproof for a full 6 hours. So Mom puts it on and cuts them loose.
Have fun, Billy!
New Copper Tone Kids 6-Hour Waterproof Sunblock. It goes on and stays on.
Why is Embassy Suites twice the hotel? First, you get a suite with two big rooms. Evening beverages are on the house, not on the bill. And our cook-to-order breakfast is free of charge. Obviously, this isn't your typical hotel. It's twice the room, twice the comfort, and twice the value. And it's only at Embassy Suites. Twice the hotel. Call 1-800-EMBASSY.
For reservations at twice the hotel, call 1-800-EMBASSY.
Your five-day business planner is sponsored by Embassy Suites Hotels. For reservations at twice the hotel, call 1-800-EMBASSY. Wednesday morning will be a wet one right along the blue line you see on the map. That is a cold front. It is the leading edge of some cooler air. And out ahead of that front is very warm, moist air provided by this high-pressure system. Now, we usually think of a high-pressure area as bringing us fair conditions. What's happening here is the winds around the high circulating in a clockwise motion, bringing in all the warm, moist air off the Gulf of Mexico. So when these two air masses the air masses clash, that's where we see the showers and thunderstorms. And another area to watch out for as this front continues to press on towards the east. High pressure's in control across the west, and there's another front that is coming in here. So watch out for rain moving in through Washington and also Oregon. Northern California could see some of those showers as well. Temperatures will correspond right with this front. It will be very warm and humid to the south overnight tonight, much cooler back to the north with 30s in the higher elevations. A hot one tomorrow. We were just talking about if you have a pool nearby and you live in Augusta, Georgia, go to the pool. You're going to need it. It's very, very hot. Now and tomorrow will be even hotter. Back across the west, some cooler air, your 60s and 70s here. Cooler, not cold, just a little bit cooler, especially when you compare it to what you're going to be seeing across the southeastern part of the country. That heat will stay in place, too, and we'll find more warmth punching up through the Plain States as we head into the weekend. Going to be a hot one. Yes, it is. Another little area of cool air sliding in here across Montana, but the rest of the United States, very, very warm. Northeast, we'll see a few temperatures in the 60s. Where's the rain going to go? Well, it's a slow-moving front, so we'll see scattered showers and thunderstorms across the eastern half of the country through Thursday, right on into Friday. Then the next batch of moisture comes across the Rockies with some showers around Boise, Idaho. All that moisture slides on out into the Plain States by Saturday. At least that's the way the models show it right now. We'll keep you updated, though, as we get a little bit closer to that weekend. Our front slides right on off the coast, so look for just a few showers right along the edges as we head through the weekend. High pressure will take over across the northeast, and that will make for some nice conditions there. The wet spot on Sunday will be in the midsection of the country with dry weather here across the western half of the United States. Well, that's the broad overview of the entire nation. Close-up look at your hometown is coming up in just a few moments.
Avoid unpleasant surprises when you travel. Watch international weather. Accurate weather forecast for Europe at 41 after the hour, every day on the Weather Channel.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the current local conditions. Today's regional forecast.
local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Local radar showing any precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
No matter how many little surprises life throws your way, there's one thing you can count on: the comfort of a Tempstar heating and cooling system. Find out how you can rely on Tempstar. Call for your nearest Tempstar dealer today and learn about reliable Tempstar heating and cooling. You'll also get this free brochure. Your Tempstar dealer is your home comfort specialist. Call him today and get comfort you can count on. Rely on the star. Tempstar.
See your Tempstar dealer for an estimate on a reliable heating and cooling system.
Matchlight charcoal has just the right amount of lighter fluid. Already added. That's why there's only one match from Matchlight. Matchlight from Kingsford.
To you, it's just appeal. To us, it's where promises are kept. Suncare. You have our word on it.
This look at the Good Evening Forecast is sponsored by Sunkist, growers of quality fresh citrus, now available at your favorite supermarket. We'll start our forecast run in the Northeast, and well, it looks like we're still going to have some showers and some thunderstorms to deal with, pushing right on up. They have been confined, the thunderstorms have, mostly to Ohio into Pennsylvania, and tonight running on down here around the Chesapeake Bay and the Delaware Bay. But I think you're going to get some showers and storms even running all the way on up into New England during the course of the day, maybe late in the day around New York City. But the biggest chance or best chance, I hesitate to say best, because there's nothing best about severe weather, but the greatest chance of severe weather back into parts of the Ohio Valley, maybe even toward the Pittsburgh area once again. As we head into the southeast, huge ridge of high pressure here. It is going to be hot. It's going to be sultry. We may see some more triple-digit temperatures in parts of Georgia or the Carolinas, particularly in the sand hills, and a hot, humid day. Maybe a couple of isolated thunderstorms down in Florida. Best chance for severe weather lining up from parts of Oklahoma into the Ozarks and on up through the mid-Mississippi Valley, right on up here into the Ohio Valley. A cool, kind of a almost chilly day for this time of the year up around Duluth, although warmer than what you've had the last couple of days. And the sun will probably peak out in the western high plains. Farther on to the west, it looks like we have a system with some rain moving into Washington and Oregon, particularly along the coastal areas, so don't expect a lot of sunshine there. But the southwest should finally start to warm up more toward what is normal temperature-wise for this time of the year, like Phoenix, almost the century mark, and Las Vegas, topping at 93.
Be prepared when severe weather threatens. Tune to the Weather Channel for the most accurate, up-to-the-minute severe weather information and forecasts. The Weather Channel, weather you can always turn to. Current regional conditions. Special regional information. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Regional forecast. The extended forecast.
Your local radar, showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
This is the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.
From the Weather Channel, a severe weather update.
The clash of two air masses tonight. Thanks for joining us here on the Weather Channel. I'm Lisa Spencer along with Jeff Morrow. We're looking at a frontal system that is pressing eastward, moving into some very warm, moist air, and that has given us numerous reports of hail, also some heavy downpours, and tornadoes have been reported tonight. This is the area where we're going to see more severe thunderstorms, so we'll have to keep our eye on the red shaded area this evening. So certainly we want you to keep an eye on the Weather Channel. Now, as far as what kind of damage we've seen, well, we can take you to a neighborhood in Ripon, Wisconsin, and pretty incredible stuff out of this area. Certainly you want to take notice of how we've had numerous trees downed as the thunderstorms rumble through and that tornado touched down earlier on today. And of course, even earlier in Chicago, high winds damaged about 17 buildings in the Morris area this morning. Trees were downed and some utility poles fell through houses. The sheets of rain that have fallen in Chicago over the past 2 days prompted Mayor Richard Daley to declare an emergency this morning. So certainly we are looking at some very nasty weather this evening. We'll have to continue to monitor this situation. There are numerous boxes. We call them boxes. What we're talking about when we say that are severe thunderstorm watches that are indicated here by the areas that you see with the yellow shading. That watch is in effect until 2 o'clock local time for parts of Oklahoma and also into Texas. Another watch area includes parts of northern Illinois and Ohio. This is a tornado watch, means conditions are ripe for tornadoes. Same goes for Wisconsin, too, with these severe thunderstorms rumbling across in advance of the frontal system. This watch for portions of Michigan until 2 a.m. local time. And for 2 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm watch. That, of course, includes portions of southwest Pennsylvania. And another watch, as you can see here, including portions of Maryland, also into areas of Virginia too. So all of those locations we will have to continue to watch this evening. And it's just amazing the reports that we have had into the Weather Channel of hail and wind and also tornadic activity. You'll have to take a look at some of these. Jeff?
Okay, Lisa, and indeed, as she mentioned, there's been just a huge amount of severe weather reports. We have a printer here in the Weather Channel studio, which has just been going almost nonstop with reports of hail and gusty winds and trees down, power outages, and confirmed tornado touchdowns. When we get a report like that, we put a little red triangle on here. I haven't counted all of these yet, but it looks like in the order of between maybe 20 and 30 confirmed tornado touchdowns from Minnesota into Wisconsin, Illinois, parts of Indiana, Ohio, and even Oklahoma. On the satellite vantage point, we still have some big thunderstorms to talk about. The orange shading you see here are the tops of the big thunderstorms. This is an infrared picture which looks at the temperature of the cloud tops, and the higher those clouds get up into the atmosphere, the colder they are. And the tops of some of these big thunderstorms are way up into the atmosphere, so they show up as the oranges. And there are some big storms here now moving down off of the Delaware coast, on up over Pennsylvania, back into Michigan, and on down into parts of Oklahoma and particularly into Texas. It's all lining up along and ahead of this cold front, which is very, very sluggishly moving to the east. As a matter of fact, it's stalled out here to the south. Ahead of that front, a very warm and unstable air mass, that warm and humid air all the way up here, and that's the northern extent of it, this warm front. And just south of that warm front, we're seeing all kinds of thunderstorms. Big cluster moving on down over the it looks like just south of the Dover area near Seaford, Delaware, and moving down toward the Salisbury vicinity. East of Johnstown, halfway between there and Harrisburg, near Breezewood, Pennsylvania, some big thunderstorms with hail and high winds. Another small cluster, just one band right after another here moving south across Pennsylvania. This one up around the Youngstown area over toward Mercer. And as we head farther to the northwest, some storms embedded in a big area of rain from Flint to Lansing to Grand Rapids and down to Jackson. And other storms around the Moline area and also Rockford. Couple of embedded storms still up around Wausau and Neenah and Fond du Lac, Wisconsin, between Joplin and Springfield, another area of thunderstorms. Then as we head on down here into parts of North Texas, just southeast of Wichita Falls, and south of the McAllister area across the Red River, some big storms there as well. All right, let's go ahead and show you what's going to be happening over the next couple of days. Our front is going to move rather quickly to the east here into New England, so that by Thursday there'll be wet weather there, but it's going to hang up here to the south. And it looks like with the front stalling here and more moisture coming up from the south, we could be setting up for some flooding potential here. We'll have to wait and see, but keep it tuned here to the Weather Channel. We'll keep you advised. And there is that front moving over the Great Lakes, again out ahead of it tomorrow from the Ohio Valley down into the lower Mississippi Valley and the southern plains. Could be some more severe thunderstorms. Big, hot, humid air mass over the southeast. Cooler for the northern plains, even showery, but the severe weather will have died down and more rain moving into the northwest coast. Again, some of these storms putting down a lot of water in a short period of time. Not everybody's going to get all that rain, but some folks could get several inches. Ahead of the system, very warm and very muggy. Behind it, look at the lows still in the 30s here in almost the middle of June out in the Rocky Mountains. There's your highs for Wednesday. Notice some darker red here in the southeast. Could be some more 100-degree record temperature set places like Augusta or Columbia. And there is a look at temperatures as we head on through the rest of this week. Another shot of cooler air moving into the northwest and the northern Rockies over the upcoming weekend. It stays pretty warm and muggy over the deep south. Our front kind of falling apart as it heads to the southeast, but there'll still be at least the chance for showers and thunderstorms moving into this area. Then a new system, and depending on which computer model you look at, the strength of this system is a little bit problematic, but we could have some more heavy weather, some scattered showers, and maybe locally heavy storms in the northern plains by Sunday. Dries out in the northeast and the west.
Hi, I'm Jim Palmer. Thinking about refinancing your home? Even if you've been late on some payments in the past, you can still refinance your first mortgage and get today's low rates at the Money Store. Because the Money Store looks at your total credit picture. They won't automatically disqualify you for some late payments. And you can apply by phone with no application fee. So even if you've been late on some payments, you can still refinance your first mortgage. Call the Money Store at 1-800-944-7198.
Avoid unpleasant surprises when you travel. Watch international weather. Accurate weather forecast for Europe at 41 after the hour, every day on the Weather Channel.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Current regional conditions. Special regional information. Local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Long-range outlook. The regional forecast. The extended forecast. Local radar showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
Why is Embassy Suites twice the hotel? First, you get a suite with two big rooms. Evening beverages are on the house, not on the bill. And our cook-to-order breakfast is free of charge. Obviously, this isn't your typical hotel. It's twice the room, twice the comfort, and twice the value. And it's only at Embassy Suites. Twice the hotel. Call 1-800-EMBASSY.
For reservations at twice the hotel, call 1-800-EMBASSY.
official forecast for summer 1993. Light to moderate breezes, cooler temperatures, and gently falling utility bills. Conditions are expected to persist for the next 20 to 45 years. Other than that, everything's quiet.
Prepare when severe weather threatens. Tune to the Weather Channel for the most accurate, up-to-the-minute severe weather information and forecasts. The Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to.
Here's that forecast for Wednesday. We have a new storm system that will be moving in across the west. This front will be bringing rain to Washington and Oregon. Meanwhile, nice conditions will be in place across the southwest. Of course, the heat will be on here in the desert areas. And there'll be some scattered showers across Idaho on down to Wyoming and into Colorado and New Mexico. So keep that in mind as you make your plans for Wednesday. Breaking it down for you, here's a look at the southern portion of California, where you'll see plenty of sunshine here, and a warm afternoon in Palm Springs up to the century mark tomorrow. Civic Center will be at 83 degrees in Los Angeles. A little farther on to the north, a beautiful sunny day and a very warm afternoon, particularly in the valleys, where you will be seeing 90 degree temperatures, much cooler, however, along the coast. Across Washington and Oregon, this is where the showers will come into play with that next front that is going to be sliding on shore. So you'll want to build that into your daily plan tomorrow with an umbrella close by. Here's our big storm maker across the central portion of the United States. This front is pressing on into some very warm, moist air, and as a result, we're seeing some strong thunderstorms firing up. Where will all this be headed over the next several days? Well, we'll have a look at that coming up just a little bit later on. Stay with us.
Hey there! I've heard you liquid detergents are doing a great job.
What are you doing in the laundry room?
Heard the news? I can help you guys clean better. Look at these smelly, dirty socks. I'll wash this sock in one of you liquid detergents, this one in the same detergent, plus Arm & Hammer baking soda. You know how well I clean and deodorize. Compare. My sock looks cleaner, smells fresher too. For a cleaner, fresher wash, use me with your liquid. Half a cup is all you need.
Every Monday, there's a heat wave. Every Tuesday, it snows. And the rest of the week doesn't get any better. Testing the reliability of Train air conditioners takes 16 miserable weeks. But when it's helping to make them some of the most durable air conditioners on Earth, you don't mind the sudden changes in weather. Designed, tested, and manufactured to last, it's hard to stop a Train.
Designed, tested, and manufactured to last. It's hard to stop a Train. Seasonal Solutions is sponsored by Reliable, Efficient Train Air Conditioning. It's hard to stop a Train.
Summer's heat. By July or August, we'll be wishing for winter and searching out some cool air conditioning. Your air conditioner will turn on and off around 8,000 times this summer. That's a lot of mechanical stress on the machine. So now, before it starts that workout, is the best time to have it checked out. The most vital parts of your cooling system, the compressor, coil and fan motor, sit outdoors, exposed to the elements all year round. Pine straw and tree leaves, insects, especially ants, even your family pet's hair can lodge around the coil or block contacts. Make sure you have the right amount of Freon. Too much is as bad as too little. A thorough inspection includes checking both inside and outside units. Your heating and air conditioning dealer can do a pre-season inspection and tune-up in about 30 minutes. And when the heat is on, it'll be time well spent. I'm Marnie Stanier, The Weather Channel.
Make sure you got smooth sailing ahead. Select from over 150 boating forecasts. 95 cents a minute. Call 1-900-WEATHER.
Okay, so your car isn't your first priority anymore. Well, that doesn't mean you have to compromise, especially with your tires. So where do you go? You got it. JRF Tire Service, your performance headquarters. JRF sells Kelly Performance Radial, built for savings as well as speed, long life as well as handling, value as well as grip. At JRF, our service is as solid as our tires and just as fast.
If great quality and great price is what you want when looking for a new carpet, Carpet Warehouse is the place for you. Hundreds of yards of carpet in today's colors and styles. Area rugs of all sizes and descriptions. Even tile. It's all at Carpet Warehouse at prices you have to see to believe. Our installers have years of professional experience to tackle even the toughest installation problems with ease. Compare our quality and price, and you'll come to Carpet Warehouse, Route 94 South in Warwick, where you get more for less.
Accurate and dependable forecasts you can always turn to. And when you're away from your television, the Weather Channel forecast is also available from the following.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the current conditions. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Nationwide. Forecast. The current local radar showing any precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
Want an adjustable bed but don't think you can afford one? Then you haven't priced Craftmatic adjustable beds recently. This Craftmatic Model 2 bed costs 50% less than these quality flatbeds. 50% less. And this Craftmatic Model 3 is just 50% of the Model 2's low cost. 50%. Craftmatic Model 3 and 2 beds adjust to all these healthful positions, provide optional heat and massage, and total body support, yet cost hundreds less than these quality flatbeds. Get our free catalog by mail, including information on Craftmatic 3s at 50% of Craftmatic 2's low cost.
Hi, we'd like your free catalog and 50% information by mail.
Certainly, sir.
It's easy. Call for this free catalog right away.
Call toll-free 1-800-831-2500. That's 1-800-831-2500 toll-free. 1-800-831-2500.
Taking a look at the tropics, first of all, we want to remind you of our series, ongoing series this week of lessons from Hurricane Andrew, running all the way through this Friday at 7:30, 9, and 9:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. The different lessons that were learned, like with building construction, evacuation, just a couple of things we'll be touching on during the course of this week. All right, the tropics. Let's go ahead and take a look at, again, during the month of June, if you're going to have development in the tropics, in the Atlantic, it would usually occur here in the Southern Gulf or the Northwest Caribbean. As we head out into the middle of the Atlantic, again, a pretty significant tropical wave, about ready to move off the coast. But again, water temperatures here are cool and the winds aloft. Too strong. They're kind of precluding any development. Bit of an upper-level trough in here. We had thunderstorms here last night. It looks fairly impressive, but again, we don't see any organization at the present time, just a flare-up and then a dying down of the thunderstorms from time to time, but nothing of a tropical nature. And as we head out here into the Caribbean, or I should say out into the Pacific, a little bit more of a cluster here in the intertropical divergence zone, but no signs of any tropical development here. So basically what we're saying is the tropics are on the quiet side. as we go ahead and take a look at what's going on in the upper Midwest. We've got some big thunderstorms here tonight, and the Chicagoland area has had a lot of rain. Also some rain on up here into parts of northern Indiana, and that just caused some more flooding problems. We had some flooding problems there last night on into early today. Residents of South Bend, Indiana were up to their windows in water. Lots of rain, up to about 5 or 6 inches worth, caused street and basement flooding. And it was just more of a cleanup day today, although there was more rain, so the problems may have gotten worse as the ground is totally saturated in these areas. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at where the severe weather watches are out right now. This severe thunderstorm watch out for North Texas and Southeast Oklahoma, Southwest Arkansas until 2. Now, for about another 10 minutes, we still have a little piece of a tornado watch in northern Illinois and parts of Ohio, and then on up into Wisconsin again for about another 10 minutes or so, and then on over into parts of Michigan. That's a tornado watch out until 2 a.m. local time. We head farther east. This severe thunderstorm watch out, southwestern Pennsylvania, including the Pittsburgh area. That's out until 2 a.m. local time. And as we head on to the southeast, on down toward the Washington and Baltimore area, parts of the Chesapeake Bay, and eastern West Virginia, that's out until midnight local time. So again, for about another 10 minutes. In fact, I think this one's been replaced with a brand new severe thunderstorm watch, which we'll get to you shortly. Again, there's where all the severe weather has been, all these red triangles where there have been reports of confirmed tornado touchdowns. It's just been a real mess of an evening, particularly on up into Wisconsin, Indiana, and Illinois. The bright orange, as you see here, the tops of still some pretty big thunderstorms, like the ones here near Salisbury in Maryland, near Hagerstown, and moving toward Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Another cluster back toward Youngstown, Ohio. And then we get a bit of a break until you head up around Detroit, Flint, and Saginaw, and Lansing. More rain there. Drying out a little bit around Chicago, northern Illinois, south, or Indiana, South Bend, getting a little bit of a drying trend, but some storms around Moline, some big storms around the Springfield area, and some very big storms in extreme northern areas of the state of Texas. All right, a quick look at the West Coast forecast. Starts off with the morning map. It has been dry in the northwest, but it looks like a new front will be moving on in here, so some more rain might be expected. Southern California, lows and high temperatures finally starting to warm back up to where it should be this time of the year. There's lows and highs warming up here too in Central California, but again, more rain on tap for the Pacific Northwest.
The official forecast for summer 1993. Light to moderate breezes, cooler temperatures, and gently falling utility bills. Conditions are expected to persist for the next 20 to 45 years. Other than that, everything's quiet.
Now, your local forecast, accurate and dependable from the Weather Channel.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the current conditions. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Cities nationwide. Forecast. The current local radar showing any precipitation in your area. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen.
What do you do when you travel? What do you see when you travel? Then what makes you think the Travel Channel is just travel? The Travel Channel, more than a place to go, it's the place to be.
For more information on the Travel Channel, please call your local cable system.
From the achy breaky to the tush push, country line dancing is sweeping across America like an Oklahoma dust storm. And now you can learn America's most popular new dances right in your own home with this great new video from Quality. Meet Diane Horner. Diane's unique teaching method will have you country line dancing in minutes. It's easy and fast. In no time at all, you'll be doing the electric slide, slap leather, honky-tonk stomp, tush push, and of course, the achy breaky. We start with simple individual dance steps and patterns at a slow beginner's beat. Then put them all together into the full dance. Finally, we show you the complete line dance, repeating the patterns over and over so you can practice right along with us. Order now and we'll send you a second hot country video, Country Partner Dancing, absolutely free. Here's how to order.
Call 1-800-356-0600. Order today and receive Country Line Dancing and Country Partner Dancing. Two videos for $19.95 plus $4 shipping and handling. Call now or send check or money order to the address shown on your screen.
And now it's time for the Michelin Drivers Report, brought to you by Michelin and your participating Michelin dealers.
What a night we've had tonight with some very severe weather moving across the Midwest. And you can see here we've got some strong thunderstorms in our forecast from Illinois right on over to Ohio and stretching right on down to the Plain States too. What we've got is a frontal system that is moving on to the east, warming and moving into some very warm, moist air, setting us up for the active weather tonight. Several watches are still in effect, this one until 2 o'clock local time, Oklahoma and parts of Texas. Tornado watch in effect from sections of Illinois on over to Ohio. There is another watch to Wisconsin and still another watch a little farther to the east, including some of Michigan, until 2 o'clock local time. This severe thunderstorm watch is in effect until 2 a.m. for southwest Pennsylvania. And this watch from areas of Pennsylvania on southward, you can see definitely that yellow shaded area under severe thunderstorm watch, 3 o'clock local time. Some of the areas are getting a great deal of rain in a short period of time, therefore flood watches have been issued across northern Illinois, right on down through Oklahoma and into Texas as well. A look at your local weather is coming up.
For regional Michelin drivers reports, call the Weather Channel Connection, 1-900-WEATHER.
Snow. You've got Michelin's new all-season MXV4. A luxury performance tire with a very special feature. Climate control. Michelin. Because so much is riding on your tires.
Find Michelin tires at this dealer near you because so much is riding on your tires.
Avoid unpleasant surprises when you travel. Watch international weather. Accurate weather forecast for Europe at 41 after the hour, every day on the Weather Channel.
Coming up, a look at your local radar. But first, the current local conditions. Conditions. Your local 36-hour forecast from the National Weather Service. Extended forecast.
special regional information. The forecast for cities nationwide. Forecast. Your local radar showing any precipitation and its movement during the past 90 minutes. Intensity is indicated by the color code at the top of the screen. You're watching the Weather Channel. Weather you can always turn to for accurate, dependable weather forecasts 24 hours a day.